bloody dust.
I could have sworn we had a few more.
Typical nobles.
How did we never hear?
There are news billets being posted every day. Not enough swords to see to them.
Clive! Oh, am I glad to see you?
Is something wrong?
It's Blackthorn. He ain't himself. And if I'm honest, he ain't been for a while. Look, normally it only takes a couple of drinks to perk him back up, but not this time. Something's getting him down. And whatever it is, he ain't telling. It's like he's lost his spark, you know? He's barely got enough fire in his belly to get the ump about stuff. But I'm thinking he might if we both bent his ear, because he respects you, innit? So, what do you say?
Fine. If you think it will help.
I knew you'd understand.
But if he doesn't want to talk, we let him be. He'll open up when he's ready.
All right. Now, he'll only smell a rat if we both turn up at once. So, I'll go first, and you can meet us at the forge. Wait a bit, then head over when you're ready.
She's taken quite a liking to Lady Cameron.
First August, and now you. What you pair up to? What's it got to do with me?
August was worried that something had been weighing on your mind. I thought you might want to talk about it.
Did you now? I told you not to stick your nose in my business. What'd you go and do?
Clive just wants to help, innit? What's so bad about that? Talk to him. You never know, you might feel better for getting it all out in the open. Please, mate. I'm worried about you.
Phil shut you up. It's nothing really. Stupid. Not the sort of thing you'd bother people about.
Why don't you tell us all the same?
Karen and I have an arrangement. I keep an eye on Goots, and she shows me what the competition's up to. Interesting arms and armor, things like that. Anyway, the other day, she shows me a cuirass she's come by. Masterpiece of level work. Light, supple, and tougher than it had any right to be. Made my stuff look like every clumsy shit. Should have brought the bastard thing there and then just to study it, but I was too proud. And now every time I reach for my hammer, I'm reminded that I'm not the craftsman I thought I was. There. You happy? You got what you came for. Now piss off.
All right. We're going. I always thought of old Blackthorn as a bit of a force of nature. Like a storm cloud full of ale. Didn't think anything could rattle him. Least of all a stupid piece of leather.
Blackthorn's always taken pride in his craft. Questioning it means questioning himself. Something tells me this is only going to get worse. If he has doubts, it will affect his work, which will only add to his problems. We need to nip this in the bud.
I couldn't agree more.
He said he should have bought that cuirass. Perhaps we should track it down for him. Assuming you're happy to help, that is.
Too bloody right I am.
Glad to hear it. First things first, then. We need to speak to Karen.
So, we find a cuirass, give it to Blackthorn, then he works out how to make it and goes back to being his surly old self, right? Simple.
That monster's taken quite a liking to Lady Karen.
Karen, do you have a moment? Blackthorn mentioned that you'd recently come by a leather cuirass. An exquisite example of the craft, from what he told us.
And he ain't been himself since he saw it. So we thought we'd buy it for him.
Sorry, sold it already. Didn't think Blackthorn cared for it the way he turned his nose up. But it were nicely put together, that's for certain. Even if the bloke who made it is a bit of an odd one. Happened across him on my travels. Makes all his stuff to order, but the fella who commissioned it refused to pay. He didn't like the colour of summer. So I took it off his hands for a fair price.
You don't know where we might find him, do you?
Like I said, he's a bit of an odd one. Doesn't even have a workshop. He doesn't trust hunters neither, which means he spends as much time out tracking beasties as he does working their hides.
I see.
He did tell me something, though. Apparently, his next commission's for a set of griffin hide greaves.
Here, there's a griffin on the hunt board. The curse breakers were placing bets on who'd bag it. Now, where the bleeding hell was it sighted? Somewhere in Sambrec, maybe. Cairn Northern, that was it.
Thank you, Karen. We'd be lost without you.
At least you admit it.
So, it sounds like going after that griffin might be the best chance we have of finding our roaming leather worker.
I'll leave the hunting to you if you don't mind. While you get on with that, I'll ask around the markets. See if I can't sniff out who he is and where he's hiding.
Good idea. Hopefully one of us will be able to track him down.
Them pilchards nice and chill.
Look at this place.
Good girl. Let's go. Thank you.
it is, the Black Shields took a hiding in the hands of some bearers in the old duchy.
Yeah, maybe you think they'll be taking that out on.
Good girl. Run like the wind.
All right. Time to fight.
Let's go.
Griffiths don't exactly make for easy prey. Let's hope our craftsman hasn't bitten off more than he can chew.
Thank you. everybody.
I heard Torgo. To me, boy. To me, boy. I heard Torgo.
Something there, boy. Could that be our man? Are you all right?
Yeah. Dare say I'll survive. That griffin caught me before I could get an arrow off. Must have lost sight of me in the grass, though. I'd be dead if it hadn't.
More likely than not.
The name's Camille. I'm a lowly leather worker, if you couldn't tell by the smell of me.
Not so lowly from what I hear. Do you remember selling to a merchant by the name of Karen?
She's not an easy woman to forget. Bought a cuirass from me after I lost my buyer. Quite taken with my work, as far as I recall. Didn't stop her bartering me down to a pittance, though. She sent you for a refund.
It's not her who sent me.
Well, consider me flattered.
You should be. He's a master of his art, and not an easy man to impress.
Blacksmiths are proud folk. It's a rare thing indeed for one to praise a glorified tanner. And I don't imagine an impressive swordsman like yourself would be getting your steel from any but the best. I'd dearly love to help a fellow craftsman, but... Well, actually, I suppose you could give him this.
What is it?
Treated leather. Same stuff I used to make that cuirass. If your man's as skilled as he sounds, he'll know what he's looking at.
You sure?
Well, you did save my life. And thanks to you, I'll be going home with all the griffin hide I can carry. I'd say it's the least I can do. Short of showing him how to make the thing myself, that is. But there are rules against it. Secrets of the trade and whatnot.
In that case, I'll see that he gets it.
I'd be much obliged if you would. Right, I've got some greaves to make. You send your blacksmith my regards.
Will do. And thank you. Hopefully this will sweeten Blackthorn's mood.
Thank you for sticking with us.
Those of us who are still here.
We can't exactly leave old Martha in the lurch after everything she's done for us.
I'll price them turnips.
Perhaps I'd live longer if I bade this town farewell. But I've grown rather fond of the old place.
But the Empire have dragoons. Wyverns.
And we have each other.
Do you know the words to the second verse of The Phoenix Sleeps in the Rosebed? One of my clients can't go to sleep without me singing him old Rosarian lullabies. Only I've quite forgotten how it goes.
Stay sharp. We don't know when those bastards will be back.
Well, we do. After what the Empire did to Martha's lot, I'd be daft to stay. If he carries on like this, I won't have any bearers left.
I understand. May the blessing go with you.
Used to come to my stall all the time, buying herbs and tonics. I thought he had a bit of a habit. But it was all for the bearers, wasn't it?
Ah, welcome.
times may be hard, but if you got the gill, I got the goods. What can I do you for?
Unwanted violets, if you have them. Though I'd gladly settle for learning what they are if you don't.
Boy, I haven't heard folk call them that since I was a lad. You're looking for scorpion tails. Unwanted violets is what folk used to call them back in the day. They turn a wicked purple when you boil them up. Hence the name. Used to chuck them in the pot when there weren't nothing else on offer. When there was a war on, that sort of thing. Thankfully, times aren't yet as hard as that. And even if they were, you wouldn't find anyone selling them these days.
Do the scorpions still live nearby?
I dare say they do. Three reeds would be your best bet, if memory serves.
Thank you. You've been most helpful.
Those of us who are still here have to...
Thank you for sticking with us.
Don't you go causing any trouble now.
Did you find our mystery ingredient?
I did indeed.
Marvelous! Let's see. What am I supposed to do with this? It's poisonous, surely.
You wouldn't be wrong. But that's your unwanted violet.
Into the pot it goes, I suppose. Wait here. I won't be long. I present Chance's Stew, risen once again from the ashes of obscurity. Grab a spoon, Sid. Let's eat while it's hot.
I'm, not hungry.
Well, it'll be too late once I've licked the bowl clean. Your loss. Mmm! assault on the senses. It's like choking on swamp water. And yet, up through the pungency, there rise complex, meaty notes. It takes a moment to recover from such an onslaught of flavours, but never have I tasted anything so fine. Thank you, Sid. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I must share this gift. I won't rest until a steaming bowl of Chancer's stew sits before everyone in the hideaway. A single mouthful, and Molly will be breeding scorpions of her own.
I'm sure she will.
That monster's taken quite a liking to Lady Callan.
And with a bit of luck, Clive might even find the geezer.
Bloody busybodies, the both of you.
How'd it go, Clive? Did you find him, or does the hunt continue?
I found him. And he asked me to give you this, along with his regards.
You're joking.
He said he wouldn't teach you how to work it, but that if you were as skilled as you sounded, you'd have no trouble understanding how it was done.
So that's his secret. Crafty bastard. He's layered and cross-grained it. Good few times, too. No wonder it's tough. And that's no ordinary oil he's used to get that finish. Oh, this is fine work. Even finer than I thought.
Yeah? I'll take your word for it. Just looks like leather to me. Still, I'm glad you're happy. Here, Clive. You didn't happen to catch the fella's name, did you?
Camille, I believe.
I thought as much. There ain't many leather workers in the realm daft enough to do their own hunting, see? And his name kept cropping up when I was asking around. Turns out he's from Tabor. And again, most leather workers are. But our friend Camille guards a long-held family secret, the details of which are the subject of some debate in the leather-working community.
Then we better keep this close to our chests.
Listen, sorry for putting the both of you to all that trouble. Should have kept my moaning to myself. Still, I'm glad you found him. This has cheered me right up.
That was the idea. Clive's idea, anyway. He did most of the work.
It's good to have you back, Blackthorn.
Just don't expect me to go turning out work like this. There's a reason he does his own hunting. He knows exactly what hides to look for. And that's how he gets them to layer up so nicely. And don't get me started on how much oiling this leather would need. But I reckon I can make something about as good. Something a Cursebreaker will have no trouble caring for. Anyway, enough narrowing. I've got work to be getting on with.
Looks like we won't be needing a new blacksmith.
As if there was a better one out there. I wouldn't have been the same anyway. No one spins a yarn like old Blackthorn in his cups. Right, now that's sorted, I've got duties to attend to. Thanks, Clive. You've given me my mate back.
What do you need? So, what'll it be?
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Come to claim your just desserts. Here you are. All done?
Back again, Lord Rosfield. I'm touched that you should find me such good company.
It is not your company, but your counsel that I seek on this occasion.
Ever the charmer. What will it be today, then?
The Iron Kingdom. I need to know what to expect.
You'll soon be setting sail for Drake's Breath, then, I take it. The mother crystal that rises from the boiling sea. There was a time when a true-blooded Rosarian had only to brave the waves to visit it. But then the Ironblood made their move. As you know, the Iron Kingdom rules over the islands to the west of Storm. Or rather, its church does. But this is not the pragmatic approach to state religion employed by the Holy Empire to manipulate the masses. No. The Iron Kingdom is the literal embodiment of the crystalline orthodoxy. And so, if one is to understand it, one must start there. As the name implies, the orthodoxy holds the Mother Crystal sacred, and they do not take kindly to heathens plundering the objects of their worship for the means to fill washtubs and light lamps with frivolous feats of magic. Indeed, the faithful consider ether a sinful thing. A poison, no less. And to them, a dominant is an instrument of evil, albeit one they have proven only too happy to turn against their enemies. Some 80 years ago, in Northern Storm, Drake's Eye collapsed. Soon after, in pursuit of Aether, and with the Blight at their backs, the Northern Territories descended upon the Grand Duchy of Rosaria. And when the Shields of the Flame marched north to meet them, the Iron Kingdom spied an opportunity. A few short days later, the Crusaders landed on the island of Mount Drastanus, home of Drake's Breath, and plucked it from the Duchy's grasp. Rosaria tried to reclaim it, of course, but to no avail. I doubt more than a handful of Duchy men have set foot on its shores in your lifetime. Nor are they like to again, under the Empire's stewardship. Meaning the Iron Blood will keep their island, and with it, the foothold they need to march on mainland soil when next they spy an opportunity. The Mother Crystal is both the object of the Iron Blood's worship and their gateway to the continent, making Drastanus the holiest of holy grounds. From which the Orthodox Crusade shall one day sail forth to claim the remaining Mother Crystals, or die trying.
My father and my grandfather both traded blows with the Iron Blood for control of Drake's Breath. Had things unfolded differently at Phoenix Gate, we would have sent our entire fleet against them.
But instead, they sent their fleet against Rosaria, sacked the capital, killed the men, and captured the women, including Jill. I'd say you'd be forgiven for wanting a little revenge, Clive.
My only aim is to destroy the Mother Crystal. But thank you all the same. Not much else to do here. Let's see if Jill's ready.
Ah, my favorite pupil. While the Ironblood may not be your chief concern, you will most certainly be theirs. Be careful, Clive.
A part of me thought Drake's head might be the last crystal we ever cracked. But I'm glad I was wrong.
Think about it. And
it'll be over soon. I think so.
Jill, when you told me you had to come to terms with your past, you weren't talking about destroying Drake's breath, were you?
No. I spoke of Imran, the leader of the Crystalline Orthodox, the man who made me do all those unspeakable things. I'm going to kill him. It's what I need to do to put the past behind me. What I need to move forward. And I know that I can do it. If you're there beside me.
Always.
And I'll be beside you, too. We'll bring down the Mother Crystal together. All while Sid looks on.
We'll make him proud.
Useful trick. Freezing and thawing the spray to make mist. How did you learn to use your powers like this?
The Masters made me do it. When the Crusaders took to the seas. To keep the fleet's movements from prying eyes. I'm fine.
No, you're not.
This may be the only chance I get to go back. My only chance to put things right. I have to do this. Whatever the cost.
All right.
She is. The Iron Kingdom's mother crystal.
Drake's breath. Strong currents, sharp rocks, and ether floods. Let's not forget them. This island is a natural fortress.
But safety breeds complacency, allowing a single rowing boat to slip in unseen.
The sanctuary is inside the mountain. If we follow the old trail, we should be able to enter by the back gate.
All right. Let's go. I always imagined when I came here it would be to reclaim it.
It used to belong to Rosaria, didn't it?
Once, though it's been in the Ironblood's clutches for far too long.
As was I. For 13 years, this rock was my home. I know its secrets only too well. This path was abandoned after an ether flood. They don't guard it anymore.
The perfect little shortcut.
All the time. That wasn't even a bad one. It's nothing to worry about.
Thank you.
old arboretum is just up ahead. We'll enter the caves from there.
Look at this place. What a mess.
Wait.
Thank you.
Press on?
Yes. It's like a furnace in here.
We're inside the volcano. You get used to the heat, though I don't remember it being like this hot.
Was that what the cause for concern?
It was. And they're getting bigger. Something's wrong.
Stay down!
Yeah.
Is there no other way across?
Do that again.
No. Let's not. Straight over to Tar.
Perhaps not alone, but in numbers like these. We're nearly at the oratory.
What the hell is that?
I have absolutely no idea.
Well, whatever it is, I don't think it's friendly.
Yeah.
lava.
If I didn't know better, I think this volcano was about to erupt.
Why attack us? They're peaceful creatures.
But this one must be the exception.
Ah!
Are you hurt?
Just hot. Thank you.
Quite a commotion our friend made. Let's hope the guards didn't hear it.
The gate to the inner chambers is just up there. Then we make for the sanctuary. I need to finish this before the heat finishes me.
Hear, hear.
We'll enter the Comrick by the Handmaiden's living quarters. It was always a hive of activity.
Sounds like we'll have a hard time staying out of sight.
We won't have to. There's someone there I should very much like to see.
Lady Marley, it's me.
By some mother. Jill, it can't be.
It is, my lady.
We cannot talk here. Come with me.
I'm so glad you're safe.
And I you.
Why ever would you risk coming back? Are you a fool, girl? Or have you grown tired of your freedom already?
Forgive me, my lady. But I had to come back. There are things I left undone. Tell me, where is the Patriarch?
At this hour, he'll be in the Comrick, giving thanks.
You mean... Oh, fiend! Clive, we have to get to the sanctuary. Now! Lady Marley, you must flee this place. Gather your things and go.
Now listen here, Jill.
In Elak, now!
We have company.
This way. Follow this passage. It leads straight to the Comrick. Go on, stop dawdling.
Thank you. You were always so kind to me. My light in the darkness. Take care, my lady, please. You deserve better than this. A long and happy life, promise me.
Promise to do the same.
Come on, Clive. We're nearly at the comrec.
All right.
Our welcoming party.
I've had enough of their hospitality.
How many of them are there?
Too many.
Orgel, kill! Now, Orgel! Get him! It's over.
Clive, there's something I need you to know. I saw the Patriarch do things no one should have to see. And so I swore that he would die by my hand.
I understand. I faced my demons. Then you must face yours.
Shiva's dominant. Come to beg forgiveness for your failure.
For years, I followed your orders. Fought your wars. All to protect the children you took. Just as you took me. And what did you do in return? In chains, and you slit their throats!
Fiend.
Their souls were sullied with a stain of ether. I merely cleansed them of their corruption. A penance paid.
just as the Holy Mother wills it! Repent, abomination! For a monster like you to set foot in the Holy Cymmrich is in itself a crime deserving of death!
You're right. I am a monster. And my soul is stained black. Though not by ether. But by the evil of men like you, who made me close my heart and drown in darkness when I should have raged against it! This is my penance. I will be your monster no more. Nor will I suffer you to create another.
Does the beast bare its teeth at its master? Come then, Dominant. Rage, be as you have ever been. A monster!
And what are you, Imran? I was forced to kill. You do it by choice. But never again. I bowed to you once. Now it is you who shall bow to me!
Kill them.
Now!
Right!
Do it!
Thank you. All right. I won't take long. Nice try. Jill!
I'm going to finish this, Clive. is this?
To it.
Oh, we destroyed it.
What? But monster, monster, do you have any idea what you have done?
I do, Father. I have killed the monster and become an outlaw. May the blessing of the crystals go with you.
It's over.
It is.
And Shiva exacted her price.
She did.
Again, the burden fell to you.
And I bore it willingly. This was a sin for which I had to atone. Now I can continue at your side with my head held high. Clive, look.
It's just like the one at Phoenix Gate. Damn it. We need to leave.
Agreed. Now you keep yours.
This way, Your Grace.
You're bleeding. I have a tonic which will...
I thank you for your kindness, truly. But I assure you, I will survive. Please. Save your medicines for those who need them most.
Oh, well, if you're sure.
For a moment there, I felt my brother's presence.
You did?
I fear he is in Ultima's thoughts again. But why now, after 5 years of silence? I cannot keep him sealed away much longer.
Your grace.
No, do not dirty your hands. Look at them all. Like a river flowing to the sea.
Or moths to a flame, perhaps. The crystalline dominion, their light in the darkness. More and more lose their homes to the blight and set out in search of sanctuary, while others lose their fortunes to the Dalmechian levies and leave to find new livelihoods. What is it that you seek in the Dominion, Your Grace?
Oh, Dion Lesage.
You mean the Crown Prince of Sanbrec?
He has many titles. Dion the Bold, Prince of Dragoons, Odin's Nemesis, or simply Bahamut. I met him once when we were children. He was a chivalrous soul even then, and has served his empire indefatigably ever since.
And you are confident that he will listen to what you have to say?
Our world lurches ever closer to the abyss. And a hidden hand ushers us onward. Ultima's influence extends to every nation, Sanbrec included. If His Highness is the man I believe him to be, and I pray that he is, this truth will not have escaped his notice. As the mother crystals fall, the eternal flame wavers, and the azure sky begins to bruise. How lucky we were to be blessed by the crystals. And yet how spoiled. Like canaries in a gilded cage, growing fat on seed. But now, the bars are closing in, and we must take flight. Painful though it be to leave our home behind, it is what we must do to be free. Which is it that men cannot live without? A blessing that leads to damnation, or a freedom that leads to deprivation? I do not yet know the answer to that question. Do you, Clive?
Your Grace, let us find a place to rest a while. We can return by the Dalmechian Trail once you have recovered your strength. I realize your duty is pressing, but if your health should fail...
I know. Thank you, Yota.
army's attempt to breach the Empire's defenses and gain the Isles of Ark has failed yet again.
Only because your fleet has proved as impotent as a eunuch on Lane Night. Would you rather we simply fell back to the capital?
Enough, both of you. All here agree that the Empire cannot be allowed to maintain its illegitimate claim on the Dominion. However, our casualties mount with each passing day.
There is a literal sea twixt you and your prize. The armies of Sambrek need but sit back and watch as you harmlessly lap against their walls. They are dug in like ticks and seek to draw out this siege, knowing the capital's stores are nigh bottomless. And what of our wise rulers? Goaded into war without any thought as to what chaos it might reap. Republican soldiers starve while waiting for orders from Randalar.
If you would but take the field, their bellies would be full by nightfall.
If I take the field, so too will Bahamut, and our duel will shake the island to its foundations. Instead of liberating the Dominion, you would doom it to destruction. Unless that is what you desire.
If our learned advisor has a solution to propose, we should be glad to consider it.
Is that the Emperor's?
What is the meaning of this, Lord Kupka?
What it means is that I am disinclined to advise you any longer. Ah, the looks on their faces when you walked through those doors. A perfect picture of stupefaction. They could not believe their eyes. Though I confess, I had my own doubts whether or not you would accept my invitation. Such shocking news. Cid isn't a son of a whore. He's the son of an empress. Your own dear Clive.
Absurd. Who fed you these lies? I have never spent a moment among criminals, save at the gallows. I came here with my son. Not to entertain your baseless accusations, but to put an end to the senseless hostilities between our nations.
Very well. You need only agree to the terms I set out. Cid took the life of someone dear to me, a woman by the name of Benedicta. I swore to take his in turn. This would not be disagreeable to you, I take it. You would finally be rid of the stain on your noble name. In return, I will leave Sanbrek in your capable hands. Your Imperial Majesty.
And all for the love of a common whore. Dominant or no, one cannot hide one's breeding. And beasts will ever belong with beasts. There are greater things in store for you, my darling Olivier. Soon enough, you shall be the crown prince of Sambrec. And when your father goes to meet Great Grieger, you shall be emperor of all you survey. The old order shall come tumbling down, and you will rebuild the world in your glorious image. Soon.
She's been in there for hours. Something must be wrong.
Is it true what I'm hearing, Sid? You cracked another crystal?
If you need help, just ask Nan. She's got a load of new stock in.
Well, don't just stand there gawping. From what I hear, the poor buggers. If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. It'd better all be here. You'll not find a better price than that. It'd better all be here. You'll not find a better price than that. Is that all?
Hunting down bearers, stringing them up. It's monstrous.
Is there something I might assist you with, Clive? And so, it is done. Yet the tale is far from over. I have compiled some new entries, if you would like to see them. Now this, I believe you will find most interesting. You wish to study the tomes? Always welcome, Clive.
Farewell, Drake's breath! All hail!
Back, are ya? Must have been hot. I know how hard it can be. So, will it be? Thank me later. Yeah, that should do ya. Not my best work, but it'll do. Yeah, that should do ya. Not my best work, but it'll do. That should do you. That it?
Let's see about planting those seeds, then.
Your leaves are looking nice and shiny today, Bohemil.
Sid, I know that when we came to the hideaway, we chose to let go of our past in order that we might focus on our future.
We did.
Nonetheless, I was wondering if... Well, I know you are from Rosaria, and I'm in need of someone with intimate knowledge of those lands. Apparently, the duchy is home to all manner of curative herbs found nowhere else in the realm. Among them is a flower called a Morganbeard that increases the potency of lesser medicines.
I can't say that I've had much practice healing. My youth was spent in the Bailey.
A shame. You see, the hideaway relies heavily upon medicines procured from afar. And when those shipments are late, well, it's our sick who suffer. If we could find this flower and learn to grow it here, we might save many lives. However, as you are well aware, Imperial occupation has rendered the roads unsafe for those like me, untrained in the military arts. Now, I'm not asking the busiest man in the hideaway to drop everything and make the journey for me, but if you happen to be in the duchy on other business...
Tell me of these Morganbeards, then.
But of course, if my old tomes are to be believed, the flowers are bright yellow and as large as goblins' eyes. Oh, and they grow in the marshes of Sorrowise. If I am to propagate them here in the backyard, I will require several samples, preferably of blooms which have already gone to seed. And before I forget, I do seem to recall learning in the course of my research that their odor has the tendency to attract unsavory creatures. Nothing you cannot handle, though, I'm sure. Morganbeards supposedly favor the dampest of climes. I would recommend you focus your search on areas of marshland.
Let us know if you find any rotten planks. I'll see about replacing them.
Supper tonight, do you think?
Boiled brown again, I reckon. Saw Molly dump a bag of bones in her cauldron. At least I think they were bones.
Sid! I hear you're planning to visit another mother crystal. How, did I hear you ask? Some habits die hard, I suppose. But you needn't worry. We're all on the same side now.
I fear I may have been hasty in giving my heart to Goat. Look past his
admittedly handsome visage, and he is little more than an overgrown child at heart. No, it is a man that I need. And who in the hideaway is more manly than Blackthorn? When I see him hammering away at a red-hot ingot, it's enough to turn my cheeks the same shade.
I don't know how you do it, working under that surly bastard.
It's easy. Just keep your head down and do exactly what he tells you.
Man and Dalimil mentioned that Kupka's guard haven't been seen there of late.
The calm before the storm, perhaps.
Oh, bother. Whatever am I to do now, Clive?
About what?
I've two dresses that need stitching, but I haven't got a scrap of linen. Those girls' rags are so threadbare. It's a wonder they don't fall to pieces. And we most certainly cannot have that. A certain amount of decorum must be maintained, even here at the hideaway. You wouldn't want the poor things going without decent clothes now, would you?
Of course not. What can I do to help?
Oh, aren't you a dear? You see, I've paid for two bolts of cloth from the drapers in Northreach, blue and red. But they don't deliver, not to places that aren't on the map anyway, so I'll need someone to take this receipt and collect them.
And you'd have this someone be me?
I would. And don't let them fob you off with anything less than what I paid for. One bolt of blue and one of red. I expect them both. Seems the draper was more than eager to take my coin from Karen when last she visited Northreach. But so far, all they've delivered are empty promises.
Depending on who you ask, this lake was either formed when one of the fallen cities plummeted from the sky, or when a giant worm dug a lair for itself.
My guess is on the latter.
Them pilchards nice and chilled.
Look at this.
Let's hope the draper has Hortense's cloth.
Might I interest you in some swan's down? Perhaps some seersucker or herringbone?
Just some linen. Two bolts. Already paid for in full.
Apologies, my lord, but your items aren't here. They were due to arrive on a caravan from Bocklad, but there's been little traffic on the road these past few days. My mother thinks it might be bandits, but she always thinks it's bandits.
It usually is. So I assume the caravan will be coming from the south.
Yes, hopefully carrying all manner of spice and sundries. Wait, you aren't thinking of...
Going to find it. That's exactly what I'm thinking.
Oh. Well then, be safe. You could just wait for the caravan at the Vale. I see you wear the Dame's brooch. They'd welcome you, wouldn't they?
She meant nothing by it, I swear.
Who's gonna buy my wares now? State your animals left them in.
But they hardly damage us all.
Is there something wrong?
If you're a bandit come to steal my stuff, you're gonna be sorely disappointed. And all thanks to this fool.
But it was you who stepped into my path.
Only after that feather brain trampled me. I demand recompense, be it in coin or the items you carry. Refuse, and I shall report you to the garrison and see you hanged.
These goods are expected in Northreach. I mean, they're not mine to give away.
You wouldn't happen to be on your way from Bocklad, would you?
I am, but did someone from the market send you? Please, you have to help me. I can pay whatever you ask.
So the fool has protection. And coin, too. Sorry, friend, but we'll be the ones taking it. Oi! Killer! It's time to collect!
I told you not to call me that. And we'd have already collected if you hadn't insisted we'd put on this little act.
Bandits!
As I told one of your customers, it usually is. Let's get this over with.
I'll deal with the bird lover. You take the handsome one, killer.
Stop calling me that! Slow, help me, boy.
All right. You made your point. killing my arse.
Did he hurt you?
No. No, thankfully. He seemed intent on letting the bandit do his dirty work for him. And he would have succeeded had the great lender not sent you. My shipment is safe, and my livelihood with it. You must allow me to reward you.
We can speak of that once you're safe in Northreach. I'll accompany you there.
So you and my mother were right. It is always bandits.
And were it not for the kindness of our free sword here, you'd be buying your order back from them at twice the price. Now, if you don't mind, I have a pressing appointment at the Vale before my return to Boklad. Farewell.
Oh, I almost forgot. I suppose you'd be wanting your linen. You'll be happy to know both bolts arrived safely along with the rest of the delivery. I've also added a few extra lengths of our finest fabrics to the bundle. Free of charge.
Are you sure?
My mother would insist. It's the least we can do for the man who saved our shipment.
How's that done then? Now it's back to Hortense with her cloth.
There was a time when cloth like that would have commanded a king's ransom. But now all the nobles have moved south and there's no one left to buy it.
Thank you for sticking with us.
Those of us who are still here have to look after each other.
Bryson.
No use calling Ambrosia now. See if they're damp enough for Morganbeards. Straight home now. Sight like on the tie. Certainly wasn't wrong about them being attracted to the flowers, though.
Yeah! All yours, Gilmore!
Bright yellow. These are our Morgan beards, all right. Well,
there's something familiar about this scent. It reminds me of home.
Hopefully this will be enough. I've had my fill of goblins.
It is rare that we see you so often in the backyard, Sid. What brings you to the gardens?
I found your flowers.
Yes, yes, wonderful. These are almost identical to the plates in my tome. Did you have any trouble locating them?
Finding them was the easy part, but it's odd. They remind me of my childhood somehow. I don't remember these flowers specifically, but you must have grown them in the castle garden. If the petals are meant to improve the effectiveness of medicines, it's possible that the core physicers grew them for the tinctures and treatments they made my brother.
If the ducal healers were convinced of their properties, that is all the more reason to begin growing our own supply here. Oh, allow me to use some of the flowers you brought me to make something that might aid you on your travels. I need only a moment to extract the essence from the petals. And here we are. A phial of pure Morganbeard extract. A single drop added to any one of your restoratives will increase its potency. At least I hope it will. Long before our forefathers came to lean so heavily on the mother crystals, they knew the secrets of the land and how to coax her blessings from the soil. It is these same techniques that we employ here in the Deadlands, and they have yet to fail us, despite the doubts of some who visit us here in the backyard.
see about planting those seeds then.
Clive, sorry again for sending you all that way. But you did get my order, didn't you?
Don't worry. I have it. I believe this will more than satisfy your needs.
Let's see here. One bolt of red, one bolt of blue. What's this? I don't recall ordering any silk or velvet or... Is this gold work? Krieger's ghost. If that devil of a draper expects me to pay for these.
You needn't worry on that score, Hortense. They were a gift. For services rendered. I can always return them if you like.
Oh, no. Oh, there's no need to be hasty now, Clive. I'm sure I can put all three to good use. Speaking of which one's most to your liking?
I don't know. This one? I suppose.
I've a mind to give a piece to Jill. Did you know she's quite the little seamstress?
I know needlecraft was amongst her lessons at the castle.
Her lessons? Oh, that's right. The two of you were raised together in Rosalith, weren't you?
Not quite together, but... When my father put down the uprising in the Northern Territories, Jill was taken as a ward to ensure that her father, the Silvermane, would keep the peace.
She's an honest-to-goodness princess then, isn't she? I could tell, you know. Some people just have that air about them. Not many round here, mind. I'd offer to sew her something that might better suit her station. But she'd most likely turn me down, as she always does. Tell me not to waste the fabric when it's better used on the children.
Don't take it the wrong way. She certainly seems to be attached to the last outfit you made her.
Oh, sometimes I think she never takes it off.
Or perhaps she'll make something for herself with your gift. Either way, I'm sure she won't turn it down.
We'll see, I suppose.
It makes me proud to see her wearing our dresses soon.
Said it'd be made of linen. I wish she didn't make her more.
Not sackcloth. I've never had a dress made of linen.
Our man in Dalimil mentioned that Kupka's guard haven't been seen there of late.
The calm before the storm, perhaps.
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back, so...
Come again. I may have more for you.
How are you doing? Anything catch your eye? Seen enough?
You'll be pleased to know we ain't heard a peep out of the Iron Blood since you cracked their crystal. Hopefully revenge is the last thing on their minds right now.
Ah, my favorite pupil. Allow me to educate you. Here's the latest information I have. Here you are. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
And how may I assist you today?
Allow me to explain. Again. Thus ends today's lesson. I've done what I can, but the rest is up to you. You need to start taking better care of yourself.
Understood. And thank you.
The curse has spread. Make sure she rests.
If it hurts, you can tell me, you know. I'll understand.
I can bear it.
But you shouldn't have to. Not anymore.
This isn't just your struggle, Clive. It's ours. And when we see how hard you fight, it inspires us to do the same. Or would you rather we left you to save the world all on your own?
No. That's not... Ignore me.
Clive, where are you?
In here.
Uh,
What's wrong?
Rosaria's under attack.
What?
This isn't the Dalmechian army we're talking about. It's the men of the Rock from Drake's Fang. Hugo Kupka's private guard. There is in hell in Rosalith. Trying to batter down the castle gates.
Looking for me?
Seems that way. Reckon old Hugo has finally worked out who Cid really is.
Then this is just another trap.
It's a trap, all right. The daddy of all fucking traps.
I'm going to Rosalith.
You're not serious. That's exactly what he wants you to do, Clive.
Look, I don't know why Kupka harbors such a grudge against Cid, but as long as it's left to fester, our world will never know peace. He has dragged the rest of Storm into this pointless war just to find me. Beside which, I'm not about to stand and watch while my home gets ground into the dirt. Hugo Kupka must die.
I've lost enough friends to that man already. I don't want to lose any more. So let's go and kill the bastard.
I'm coming too. After all, we're in this together.
All right. I should probably speak to Otto before leaving. We need to know what we're getting ourselves into.
Back to Rosalith, then. Whatever has become of her.
First he wrecked our home. Now he's wrecking yours. But he's not going to get away with it this time.
Sid.
Oh, you're not leaving already, are you?
Hunting down bears.
Ivan's newest dish is a masterpiece. Once you get over the urge to gag, that is.
Lady Hortense said she'd give us our dresses.
It makes me proud to see her wearing my dress.
I only wish she'd let me make her more.
I've never had a dress made of linen.
We must be ready to leave for Rosalith at a moment's notice.
Don't worry. Everyone's prepared.
Gov gave you the news, then.
We're leaving for Rosalith. But not before I know exactly what's going on. What have we heard?
All sorts. Nobody was expecting the Dalmechs to open up a new front against the Empire, least of all our friends in the provinces. Reports have been rolling in from all over the place, with no two saying the same thing. I've been passing them on to Vivian, in the hope she can make sense of them. If you're set on going, you'll want to talk to her.
Understood.
Vivian's got all the information you need. Just don't do anything stupid with it, all right?
Whatever you do, don't let Jill prime. Her body can't take it.
I'll prepare a sleeping draught for you.
I fear I may have been hasty in giving my heart.
Ah, if it isn't my favorite pupil. Let's see now, where did we leave? Well, this is a surprise. My lectures are rarely so well attended.
You know what they say? A little knowledge, can't hurt?
We're going to Rosalith to deal with Kuka. What's the situation there?
Whoa there, Lord Rossfield. I'm sure you're champing at the bit to return to your roost. But to fully understand the present situation, one must first understand how it came to be. Let us begin with the story of Hugo Kupka, or the permanent economic advisor to the Dalmekian government, to give him his formal title. In a republic founded on commerce, there could hardly be a more influential position. It has granted him both extraordinary wealth and extraordinary power. Not that he ever wanted for the latter. Being Titan's dominant, he is also Dalmekia's last line of defense, a fact he has used to his considerable advantage. Why, he was even able to pry Drake's Fang, one of the pillars of the Republic, from Parliament's grip. And he was quick to buy the loyalty of the Fang's protectors. Today they are his faithful creatures, a private army in all but name. The selfsame army that marches upon Rosarian soil as we speak. By which I mean Imperial soil, not that you need reminding of the fact. Suffice it to say, the Empire's attentions are elsewhere at present, deadlocked as it is with Dalmekia over its occupation of the Crystalline Dominion, where its legions are now gathered. Scarcely a handful of garrisons remain to secure its western provinces, and half of them left after the fall of Drake's Breath. With the threat of the Ironblood thus diminished, they had little cause to fear a maritime invasion. And so today, only a token force guards the former duchy's shores, as Kupka was quick to descry. He landed his troops on the Rosarian coast without encountering so much as a single ship. All for you, Clive. He wants your head. And so he and his men advance upon Rosalith, not to capture the province, but to draw you out.
You said Kupka's forces sailed up the coast. What of Port Isolde, then? Is the city safe?
Quite, according to the Guardians of the Flame. The Dalmekian fleet floated by without incident, but not without remark. When they learned Kupka's forces were making for Rosalith, our friends were quick to begin arranging the exodus of her citizens. And so the stage will soon be set for your heroic homecoming. Alas, it will be a more trying task to enter the capital than it was to leave it. Hugo's men hold Bewit Bridge, despite the Imperial's repeated attempts to wrest it back from their grasp. And they were careful not to repeat the Empire's mistake in neglecting their coastal defenses. The seas around Rosalith are firmly under Dalmekian control. So tell me, pupil mine, what do you believe to be the best route to Rosalith?
The north. We cross the northern border near Phoenix Gate, then take the road through Stillwind down to the capital. Hardly the quickest route, but at least we won't be spotted.
A little local knowledge goes a long way. And so must you.
We'd best get a move on, then.
Oh. Will you be going, too?
Aye. I've been waiting a long time to give that fucker a taste of his own medicine. I would have missed this for the world.
All right. We should be on our way.
Lead on.
Stay sharp. We don't know when those bastards will be back.
Thank you for sticking with us.
Those of us who are still here have to look after each other.
It will take ages to tidy all this stuff up.
Thanks, girl. Too slow. That's better. It came, and to ruin it returns.
How do you? There you go. Much obliged. There you go. Thanks very much. Much obliged. There you go. Much obliged. That all, is it?
know your trouble!
Let's go.
Run like the wind.
Come on. Be safe.
Kill! Six!
yours, Torgal.
Easier without him at their gaze.
We're doing this together, all right? I want that bastard dead just as much as you do.
This is our chance, Clive, to put an end to Kupka's madness once and for all.
You give that rotten sod exactly what he deserves.
We must be ready to leave for Rosalind at a moment's notice.
Don't worry.
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back so soon. Here you are. All done?
You go and give that bastard one from me. But make sure you come back here in one piece, eh?
Sid? Honestly, Sid, you're too nice for your own good. Do you hear that, ladies and gents? The next round's courtesy of the realm's most benevolent outlaw. Don't be a stranger, Sid.
Take care, Clive. Hugo Kupka's proper nasty, like. And clever, too.
Well, don't just stand there gawping. Come again.
Oh, don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
Back, are you? So, will it be? No scratches, right? And how am I meant to do that then? Anything else?
Why are your feathers black, Mr. Crow? Is it because you spent too long in the Deadlands?
Let us know if you find any rotten planks. I'll see about replacing them.
Us, are you?
Knowledge is yours. I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. You wish to study the tomes? You are always welcome, Clive.